This was a closely watched day in the trial of Derek Chauvin, the former police officer charged with the murder of George Floyd. It featured key testimony about what led to the death of Mr. Floyd. Special correspondent Fred De Sam Lazaro has our report.
Prior to coming to Hennepin County,
a key and highly anticipated witness today was medical examiner Dr. Andrew Baker, who performed the initial autopsy on George Floyd's body. Baker determined Floyd died of cardiopulmonary arrest and declared his death a homicide, meaning simply a death caused by the actions of another person.
That's really just fancy medical lingo for the heart and the lungs stopped. The heart, no pulse, no breathing. And in my opinion, the law enforcement subdual restraint and the neck compression was just more than Mr. Floyd could take by virtue of those heart conditions.
Prior to the trial, there had been some confusion about Baker's autopsy findings, and today both the prosecution and defense tried to parse their report to make their case, arguing over the role controlled substances may have had in Floyd's death.
So my opinion remains unchanged. It's what I put on the death certificate last June. That's cardiopulmonary arrest complicating law enforcement subdual restraint and neck compression. That was my top line then. It would stay my top line now.
And so if we look at the other contributing conditions, those other contributing conditions are not conditions that you consider direct causes. Is that true?
They are not direct causes of Mr. Floyd's death. That's true. They're contributing causes.
The state will call for
the prosecution began the day's testimony by calling Dr. Lindsay Thomas to the stand. She's a forensic pathologist who helped train Baker.
There's no evidence to suggest he would have died that night, except for the interactions with law enforcement.
Members of Floyd's family are expected to testify early next week as the prosecution wraps its case. The defense will begin calling its witnesses soon after. For the PBS NewsHour, this is Fred De Sam Lazaro.